Is my smartphone or smart device listening in on me? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the scenario that I think a lot of people feel that they've experienced. You're having a conversation with someone about something. I'll use coffee makers since I tend to use that as an example a lot. Shortly after the conversation ends though, you see ads for coffee makers. Lots and lots of coffee maker ads. So, was someone listening? Did they use what they heard to target you with advertisements? My position is that it is extremely unlikely for several reasons, but I know that there are many people who are absolutely convinced that it's happening. So let's clear up a little bit about what these smart devices are and I believe aren't doing. Are they always listening? Well, yes. They have to do their job. They're listening specifically for the wake-up word. In other words, you say the wake-up word, which I'm not going to say here because I have an Amazon Echo within earshot. But if you were to say something like, "Hey Google," for your Google device, or the wake-up word for your Amazon Echo, that's what they're listening for. They need to be prepared to activate when they hear that wake-up word. Now, that listening for wake-up words happens on the device. In other words, the internet isn't really involved. That's why, I believe, you really don't have a huge choice of wake-up words you can use. I would love to change the wake-up words on my Echoes to be something other than what they are. But you get a choice of maybe 3 or 4, and that's it. The reason is, of course, that the processing to detect those wake-up words has to happen on the device. By having only a limited number of wake-up words, well, the device can be optimized for that. If it were a more generic, you can set any wake-up word, the device is going to have to do a lot more work, typically more work than that device is capable of. But what that means to me is that listening for the wake-up word, it's happening on the device, and therefore, it's not something that's happening across the internet. Are they always sharing? Well, no, I don't believe they are. Even though the device is constantly listening, as I said, that audio that it's hearing is going no further than the device until it's woken up, until you actually proactively try to use the device. As it turns out, this is super easy to confirm. Watch your data usage. Always sharing your audio would mean constantly uploading the audio to the service. That's a lot of data. And you almost certainly would notice, especially if it's a mobile device and you've got a limited data plan. You can test it yourself. As friends and I have, within earshot of the device you're concerned about, have a brief conversation about something you've never discussed before, never searched for before, and never purchased before. Something you've never expressed any kind of interest in whatsoever. Then, wait. See if you get ads. If they do, it's almost always because one of those nevers I just mentioned actually did happen. It's also easy for professionals, networking professionals, to confirm. Tools like Wireshark can be used to monitor your network traffic. While the traffic itself might be encrypted, the amount of traffic and its source are easily determined. Needless to say, in all the years that these rumors have been making the rounds, no one has yet confirmed that these devices are reporting your conversations. Now, it need not be a coincidence. There's more data leaking from your device and your activities than you probably realize, and audio doesn't have to be involved at all for your personal preferences and for your plans to be shared. Look at car shopping. You visit a car dealer, and shortly thereafter, you start seeing ads for that brand of car because your location was shared. Or perhaps you're making a purchase at a large department store and you start seeing ads for things at that store coincidentally, maybe even the product you bought. By and large, your location is being shared, and it's very possible what you purchased was being shared. No audio involved. Another example is research. You talk about buying that coffee maker, and as part of your discussion, you grab your phone and do some online research. It's not the discussion, but the research that exposes your interest in coffee makers. Many people forget that a very simple search can expose your interest in a particular topic. They prefer to believe it's the more sensational, always listening conspiracy theory. Now, sometimes it's other apps. Particularly on mobile devices, every app you install to which you allow microphone access can misuse that access. I'd be shocked if it dovetailed into targeted advertising, but to be fair, it's absolutely possible. The key here, of course, is to only install apps from reputable sources. Always take the time to understand what it is you are installing. Pay careful attention to what permissions you give it. These are easy to overlook in the heat of the moment and the urgency of installing the latest new app. And yes, coincidences can happen. They're bound to. But more often than not, it's simply the result of information advertisers have collected already that allows them to target you or your device or your account with ads specific to your interests. It gets spooky when those interests seem to be updated instantaneously. I get it. Regardless of how it happens, it can feel kind of creepy. Personally, I tend to just laugh. But many people are concerned about what this type of occurrence implies. I continue to maintain that you and I just aren't that interesting. Not interesting enough for the expense involved to track us as individuals. However, as anonymous people who visited a Toyota dealer or bought a coffee maker, yeah, that is very, very valuable. But it's not the audio that's making that happen. So, of all the privacy issues you can worry about, and for many people, there are many, I honestly believe you can take always listening audio off the list. What we attribute to being listened to is almost always explainable in some completely different way. Regardless, pay attention to the permissions you grant these devices, particularly for data sharing. If there's a way to restrict that without losing the functionality you need, that can be a good idea. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174610. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.